Hello, Arirang viewers. I'm Eloise, the MC of Cooking Possible. No matter where you are, no matter what you have in your kitchen, you get to enjoy and learn how to cook the trendy, healthy, and fantastic tasting Korean food with us. Before we start, let me introduce the special guest for today. First member is Ms. Jung-hae Jung, who is the storyteller of Korean food and also the president of Creative Culinary Institute of Korea. Woo! Welcome. And here are the 5-6 lovers, San, Tina, Soyeon, Wenji, and George. Woo! Woo! Welcome to Cooking Possible. Okay, Sam.
Yes.
Are you excited?
When it comes to food, I'm always excited, to be honest. Whenever I have the opportunity to be able to eat some really good food, that just makes me super excited. And for me, I live to eat, not eat to live.
Oh.
Yeah. If I had to pick three, I'd probably say 팔국수,
oh.
고등어회, uh-huh. and 건드레밥.
건드레밥, I don't think I've actually tried that before.
No,
no I never. Is it
really?
Good? Is
yeah,
it good?
You're missing out on so much.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, next time I definitely gotta try it.
Okay.
Yeah.
And Soyeon, you look, from your looks, I assume you're a vegetarian.
No, definitely not.
Are you that? Does that mean that you're a meat lover?
Yeah, I'm really a meat lover.
Okay.
I eat three portions of meat, obviously.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
You eat meat for breakfast?
Yeah, I really. Usually I do.
Whoa.
Wow.
Wow.
You know, like
how do you keep yourself so fit?
I work out, but yeah, it kind of, you know, thanks to my mom.
Okay, she's inborn, all right. All right, I guess somebody's gonna be really excited today. Well, let's find out what the main ingredient is, and let's find out. Ingredient of today is beef.
Yeah.
Are you excited?
Super excited.
We get to eat, right? We're not just watching them cook.
Well, it's up to me. I get the power. Just kidding. I heard that, you know, 소고기 or beef, it's called 소고기 in Korean, and it's really, really good and among the favorites of Koreans, and not only Korean, I think from people from all over the world. Sam,
yep.
What's your favorite Korean dish if you can have something? Well, we have two chefs ready.
But yep. I think when it comes to Korean food, the two beef dishes that you most think of are probably bulgogi or also galbi-jjim.
Mm-hmm.
In Australia, we tend to cook our meat on the barbecue.
Mm-hmm.
But in Korean, it kind of, there's a lot more of a, I guess, a stew, kind of a mm-hmm. marinade that goes with it.
Right.
So it's going to be interesting to see which, I guess, which direction we go with. I'm mm-hmm. looking forward to it.
Okay. The Korean dish is maybe has a prejudice that it might be very difficult to cook. But however, let's, you know, we'll help you out to make this easier. Now it's time for us to invite the two handsome chefs. All right, please welcome Jin-ho and Lion. Woo! Woo! Hello, hello, hello.
Hi.
I heard that your name is Ryan, and I see Lion on your name tag.
That's true. All the time I've been in Korea, mm-hmm. Often people will say, oh, Lion, like Saja, like Lion.
Saja.
And I finally just decided to go with it.
Oh, so, cool.
It used to actually bother me when I first got here, but mm-hmm. But hey, you know, R's and L's are interchangeable.
Right.
It doesn't bother me anymore.
Yes.
If you look kind of behind this name tag, it has
it's Lion, yes. You know? Okay, Jin-ho, welcome. Welcome to the studio. We're very happy to have you here.
Yeah, I'm glad to be here today, and I'm very excited. And I'm very excited to try Chef Ryan's food. Lion? Mm-hmm. Is it Lion?
Lion, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you think you can win Lion?
Oh, I don't know, because he's an American chef, and he's got pretty good stuff today.
It's going to be a challenge. We got two different things going on, but I think they'll both turn out pretty good.
Yes, just like Lion said, the two chefs went to two different places. Let's figure out what they are.
So here we are today. There's a lot of people around here. Everybody's hungry. It's lunchtime. Let's go around the corner here to this old, this like 50-year-old restaurant. Let's go in and check it out.
Oh, that looks really good. Oh my. Oh.
I didn't eat lunch or breakfast
basically
deliberately.
Torture right here.
Yeah, this is torture, yeah.
This dish, it's called beef rice stew because traditionally the rice would go inside. I'm gonna try it without first. Oh man, it really is good. I can see why this restaurant's been here for so long. Everything is really nice and tender, but the bean sprouts, they're not like mush.
Wow.
It's really nice,
really
kind of pop or crunch almost in the texture on these, just right.
How he eats it
yeah.
as well.
Oh my God.
He's like shoveling it into his mouth.
That's finished on mukbang, seriously.
It's really good.
Do you see Korean style of house, Hanok, back there? Hanok has a long history of Korea. The cuisine we'll do today here is absolutely amazing. So let's go and check it out.
한 80년 됐다고 제가 들었어요.
예, 은행나무도 두 그루가 네. 있는데 2년 네. 정도 됐거든요.
네, 오늘의 요리 갈비찜이 나왔습니다. 제가 한번 먹어보겠습니다. 아, 정말 맛있어 보이는데요. 이렇게 갈비찜이 젓가락으로 살짝만 밀어내도 이 살이 떨어질 정도 이렇게 잘 익었어요.
You have to use your fingers.
That's what I like about 갈비찜. So tender.
아, 아 어떻게 갈비찜이 입에서 녹아. 그리고 제가 지금까지 봐왔던 갈비찜보다는 조금 색깔이 연해요. 간장이 이렇게 많이 들어갔다고 생각이 들지 않고 그냥 고기 육수에 삶아놓은 이게 땡기면 그냥 나오면 돼. 그러니까 돌려가지고 먹는 거거든요. 이게 돌려서 나 이렇게 먹어본 적은 처음이에요. 어떻게 갈비를 이렇게 돌려서 먹습니까? 아 너무 맛있다.
All right, we found it. This is the place. Okay, we've come about an hour and a half north of Seoul now to another sogogi gukbap place. What's special about this place is they use kamasot, which is a giant cauldron. You can do enough portions for 600 people in one cook. Let's go in and take a look.
That makes everything taste better.
Yeah.
Kamasot?
Kamasot.
Your rice in that is delicious.
Oh, it's pretty.
Lots of the ogoji here, which is like a Napa cabbage leaf. Then look at the pieces of meat. They're like chunks rather than the little strips. Oh, that's good. It's
it's really heartwarming again, the kakdugi, or the radish kimchi, here in-house. They have the ability to really pair these together, so they should match really, really well. Yeah.
It's like Lion's been doing this for his whole life. He seems so natural.
I was enjoying that, really.
Buncha. All right.
Yeah, 오늘 간장이 들어간 궁중 갈비찜을 드셔보셨다면 이제 매운 갈비찜을 드셔보실 차례인데요. 이 집은 연예인들이 많이 오는 걸로 유명한 집입니다. 그래서 스타의 맛집을 한번 가보겠습니다. 근데 여기 뭐죠? 아니, 마늘이. 벌써 시작부터 이 마늘이 이렇게. 이 분명히 마늘을 굉장히 많이 넣는 갈비찜일 것 같습니다. You saw the garlic, the amount?
Yeah.
They're using one day.
What?
One day.
One day.
Yeah.
Are you okay? Let's try it. 5,
4, 3, 2, 1.
뭔가 아까 먹었던 그 궁중 갈비찜이랑은 완전 차원이 다른 뭔가 좀 매콤해서 젊은 층을 좀 타겟으로 만든 그런 메뉴 같고요. 굉장히 부드럽습니다, 고기가.
Was it super spicy?
No, it wasn't super spicy. It was just mild spicy. Not too much chili in it, so much garlic in it.
한번 먹어볼게요. 보시면 마늘이 벌써 막 마늘이 소스예요, 마늘이.
경북 의성 마늘.
정말 좋은 마늘을.
When garlic is, you know, heated, yeah? it gets really, you know, it's sweet, it has a sweeter taste.
Yeah. Mm. 근데 아까 보니까 갈비가 이렇게 뭔가 LA 갈비처럼 돼 있더라고요.
네, 갈비를 LA 갈비통을 내가 두껍게 4cm에서 5cm 가까이 두껍게 썰어주라. 네. 그렇게 두껍게 썰어서 갈비찜을 하면 잘라서 먹을 게 있잖아요.
근데 먹으니까 정신이 바짝 드네요, 진짜. 아, 정신이 바짝 들어요.
우리 아, 정말 맞아요.
괜찮아요.
괜찮아요.
감사합니다. 오케이.
이거를 물을 계속 번갈아 가면서 이틀 동안 물을 갈아 줘야 돼요.
And here we need to make this tender and make it really clean flavor for the broth.
That's after 12 hours
wow.
in there. So it gets really good and tender.
This is a really common Korean ingredient. It does add some sweetness and it's a lot has a lot of health benefits. There's so many of these soups in Korea that have this ingredient.
There were a couple of pieces I didn't get in completely clean, and she yelled at me a little bit.
Oh, what was that?
약간 들어가야 돼요. 시원한 맛이 나요.
We did add a little, which is sometimes unusual for this recipe.
So they gave you secret recipe. After all.
Not all the secrets, no. Mm-hmm. She still held a couple. Mm-hmm. We tried.
This is a really common
Just want to say thank you so much. Thank you for working so much.
Galbi가 이렇게 통으로 오네요. 예. 하루 정도 이제 불에 잠겨가지고 핏물을 빼줘야 되거든요.
아, 핏물을 네. 하루 정도?
예.
이게 하루에 다 팔리나요?
예, 저희 거의 하루에 이 정도에 합니다.
이게 하루에 다 팔린다고요? 예.
네. 여러 가지가 들어가요.
네네.
Everything's a secret at this place.
Yeah. Tell us.
It's all secret.
What is it?
The whole bowl. We will tell you later.
See, everything's a secret.
Yeah. 이 간장하고 물 비율은 어느 정도?
4대 1. 네, 4대 1.
아, 4대 1.
제가 잠길 정도로 물을 모아 꼭 20분 정도 끓여주시면 돼요.
아, is it pumpkin in there?
That looks
no, I can't,
really
I can't say that right now.
Wow.
I'll tell you later.
국물이 오래 졸여도 네네. 짜지지가 않아요.
아, 제가 전 세계 조리장님의 비법을 네, 전파하도록 하겠습니다.
감사합니다.
네, 감사합니다. 네.
Wow, wow, wow. We have two different kinds and it's completely different. Well, especially from Korean's perspective, well, we had galbi-jjim and 소고기 국밥. So, 갈비찜 is actually, it's very fancy food, to be honest. It takes very, very long time. But, you know, in terms of 소고기 국밥.
Hey, everybody loves ribs and everybody loves meat, but you know, you gotta love a hot soup on a cold day, too. It's a little chilly today. So
yes, yeah. It's winter, definitely. Right, Jin-ho, isn't 불고기 more common or famous than 갈비찜?
Yeah, pretty sure the 불고기 is more famous. Overseas. Everyone knows about bulgogi, this Korean food. Mm-hmm. But I wanted to try galbi-jjim today because galbi-jjim is almost same seasoning as bulgogi. Bulgogi, they use like rump beef or brisket. Mm-hmm. Galbi-jjim, they only use ribs.
The ribs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So when I cook galbi-jjim today, you guys gotta look carefully because I'm gonna turn the bulgogi into the galbi-jjim just like that.
Oh, wow. So killing two birds with the stone.
It almost feels like this is almost an unfair fight because when we think about galbi-jjim, it's almost like a food that royalty used to eat, whereas gukbap is something
it's for more common people.
Yeah, it's more of the common people. So it's almost like there's quite a big imbalance in terms of who used to eat these foods. So it's going to be interesting today to
totally
see how both
agree.
Of them go.
Right. Well, in terms, you know, but you know, from my perspective, well, since bulgogi is the special menu selected as the food for Pyeongchang Olympics 2018, so don't you think it will be much easier to win Lion if you have chosen bulgogi instead of galbi-jjim?
I think anything can beat gukbap.
Okay. Would you take the challenge?
What do you think about that?
Would you take the challenge? Now you have to open a secret recipe.
You know, when you look at food from around the world today, the most famous dishes from each country tend to be the ones that the masses had, that the common people had throughout history. You know, if you're in Brazil, it's feijoada, you know, which was not royalty food at all. You know, it was all the worst parts of the pig. And with sogogi gukbap, you know, you're just using the brisket. The brisket is so tough. That's why you have to cook it for so long.
Lion's food gukbap is, we don't use that all, but it can be useful ingredient in the future because it's tough and takes a long time to cook, but it's good in like, you know, make a soup, it will be great.
Okay, two different cuts of beef and two different kinds of Korean dish. Now I can't wait and we can wait at all. All right, let's get started.
First thing, it's radish. These giant Korean radishes. This one is kind of spicy, like the smaller radishes in the West.
Yes.
When it's raw, But then when it cooks down, it gets really sweet.
Really sweet, yeah.
But do like kind of little cubes. Yeah, so that's the first step. We actually have the stock from the restaurant.
Oh.
Because we don't have 12 hours to make stock right now.
I see.
I'm going to take that stock and then the same ingredients and try to recreate that flavor.
Okay.
Jin-ho's over here. He's like, he's into it already.
What is he bringing in? Is his recipe that much more difficult here
and yours that much easier?
Actually, a little bird told me that his was already done.
No. It's not done yet.
Yes, you already brought all the meat out here.
Yeah, this is beef ribs.
Uh-huh.
And this one is I soak in the water for 12 hours.
12 hours?
Yeah.
If you don't have much time, about 2 or 3 hours is okay.
That's okay. 2 or 3 hours but is also okay.
If you want to perfectly remove all the blood and, you know, all the scum out, then you have to put more than that.
To make it clear taste or...
Ooh, the sound!
Okay.
Basically, we want something, this would be the biggest size.
Mm-hmm.
You could probably do that in half.
Half.
That might be a little smaller. So somewhere in between those.
Mm-hmm.
My wife recently found out that if you have a headache,
uh-huh.
if you slice up the radish and put it on your forehead,
uh-huh.
it helps. Yeah.
Really?
I've never heard of
headache.
That yeah. Really?
Well, I know that if you're sick, like, and you have like digestive problems, it helps with digestive problems as well. So.
I've heard that it's really good for like liver cleansing.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so I'll let you do it.
I should probably
show you a chef.
Oh, thanks, Sam.
Well, he's helping me
out.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're the expert and engineer.
Some like,
what's Sam doing in the
wooden?
Kitchen?
If you can get this one, Lee, you can get like, if you can extend something over.
That doesn't mean that he gets to eat first.
If you've got, you have to go.
Oh, here you go. Thank you, Sam.
You're a chef, right?
Yeah, I'm a chef.
Okay, just check it. Just check it.
I'm sure I'm chef. I'm gonna put beef ribs now into the stock.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna boil it.
So you're putting a lot of ribs in there.
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm gonna put a lot of them. I'm gonna do the secret thing. Secret ribs.
Already?
Yeah. I gotta cut it now. So can I show you now?
Sure, sure, okay. Go ahead. Can't wait.
Do 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 do.
Do 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 do.
Oh yeah.
Alive?
Ah.
Okay, I thought it was something alive.
I know.
Really?
Secret ingredient.
Okay.
Hang on.
Yeah. Wow.
Pears.
This
pineapple,
is pear. This
apple.
Is naju bear, which is a Korean
naju.
Bear. And they use pineapple.
Ah, oh. I
think
heard
that's
that before.
That's why this is secret ingredient.
You're still cutting.
I want these tender sweet parts from the inside. I want it to be really consistent.
Mm.
If I had the skin on there, then it might not be as consistent. That part might be a little chewy or something.
Uh-huh, okay.
Yeah.
But,
ooh, what are you taking out there? What is that?
This is stock that we got from the first restaurant we visited. And these are Korean beef femur bones.
Femur.
Right. So have you guys ever tried bone marrow?
Anybody ever had bone marrow?
This is what you get the delicious bone marrow from. But in this case today, all of that bone marrow, all of that collagen, has turned to gelatin and gone into the stock. So that was the 12-hour process that we don't have time to do here, so we borrowed from the restaurant. So we have the real deal from the restaurant. So I'm gonna get this heated up. We'll get a little brisket in there and get it to start boiling because it has to get tender.
Wow, yeah, collagen. You're definitely the reason why the Korean lady or females have this good, fair skin, yeah?
Ooh, he's putting it in the bag.
This is actually, right now, I feel incredibly frustrated sitting here.
Mm-hmm.
I want to go and actually see what's happening. I can't stand this. Oh, this is going to be a process. It's going to take a bit of a while, though.
Yep. So I'm going to put this in here and pour it together.
Mm-hmm. And ginkgo nuts.
Ginkgo nuts. This for the garnish.
Ah.
Yeah, you can have it.
I knew that.
I'm hungry.
Then will the fruits make the soup sweeter?
That's why they don't use much sugar in it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. When it's boiled and when it's ready, it's already sweet. But it's not sugar sweet.
No.
It's a fruit sweet.
Oh. Right, yeah. Right. It's all natural taste.
I don't know about this cooking with bags. where did you learn that trick?
They
from
the restaurant.
Culinary school?
Yeah, but you know, Korean women, they love bags.
Yeah. Oh, that's true. Not only Korean women. Wow. Not only Korean women, all women.
Yeah, all women. But all especially women. Korean women.
Do you have a girlfriend, you know?
No, I don't.
Okay, yeah.
Boys,
wait till you get married.
Chef Ryan, he don't have girlfriend as well.
Oh, okay.
Lonely boy.
All right, guys, we have only 20 minutes left.
Oh, no.
Yeah, you've got to hurry.
Oh, no. This brisket, you can see the blood here. This is just fresh brisket. And if I tried to give you an idea, if I tried to make a steak out of this, it'd be the worst steak you've ever had in your life. Uh-huh. We've got to cook this for quite a while to get it tender. In Texas, we might cook this in a barbecue for about 24 hours.
Wow.
Now this piece here has been soaking for 12 hours, or 2 days, I guess, actually, to get the blood out. Uh-huh.
Which one do you think you're gonna pick?
You mean the food or?
The food. I mean, oh, yeah, both maybe. Jin-ho, you're picking Jin-ho or Jin-ho's food?
Both, both. Hey, I'm free.
Love over here.
Welcome to the love connection here on Arirang TV.
I wonder who's faster in chopping.
Oh, is that a race?
Is that a race? Yeah, I think so.
Oh, I'm finishing. What is it chopping?
Oh,
spring green onion. Spring onion.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, kind of
like. Is he making kimchi? It looks like a.
Gakdugi, maybe. They have different kinds of green onion in US. Do you have this kind? No.
They have a much smaller.
I think it's like smaller overflowing.
But then they have leeks, which is closer to that.
Uh-huh. Right. This is similar to leeks.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What are you chopping there, right?
These are. let's see. Let's make sure.
Oh. Ooh. You okay there?
It's just a regular green chili. It's not.
Are you sure? It's not like the. Are you sure?
You're brave man.
You're okay? You're not getting
sick. No problem.
Want to try?
Sure, you're going to try that. I don't want to pick it up.
I'll try it.
You want one?
I'll stay in this.
They're not hot at all.
Let's see how hot they really are.
Oh. Let's go.
Okay. No, he's not okay.
I'm sure he's
hungry. Oh, dogs!
I can smell it from here.
Are you really? It smells good. Really? Okay.
Is this a chili pepper? You sure this isn't capsicum? This has no spice in it whatsoever.
I could use a little more heat, but hopefully we'll have some from the red pepper powder here too.
I think these are two different. I think these are two different chilies.
Is it crying now?
Water.
No, not water, not water.
Are you sure?
Do you have olive oil?
Olive oil?
No. Oh, what for?
To get rid of spice, oil is a much better alternative.
Really?
No thanks.
So you should never drink water, you should never drink milk. Just drink some oil.
Now, I think I should have you as a chef here. Oil? Like, not even garlic, just drink it?
Just out of a spoon, just drink a little bit and it will get rid of the.
The galbi-jjim is smell is like.
Is it good?
It's all over the place.
It's all over the studio, so I'm like really hungry.
You almost done?
Almost done, yeah.
Is there chestnuts in there too?
I don't know. I have to taste first. Yep.
You almost done over there, Jin-ho?
Yeah, I'm just waiting.
Yeah. What are you waiting for? For line to finish?
No, to be cooked. Because this is, the meat is pretty tough at the moment.
From the look of it, technically this should be the more difficult recipe.
Yeah, that's right.
But from the look of it, you make it look a lot easier than what Lion's trying to do over there.
Because of back. Yeah, I'm using the.
Oh, it's great so far. Oh.
Yeah,
yeah.
So far.
Yeah. So far.
Can I try yours?
Oh, you don't want to taste that yet.
I mean, I don't.
What is it?
It's pretty white in here.
It's water.
It's water.
Is it water?
It's water that's been cooking with these bones for 12 hours, and then now the brisket's gone in there. But there's no salt. There's no soy. There's no red pepper flakes.
How is it, Sam?
What do you think?
Wow! It tastes like water with just a hint of meat. It doesn't really taste like anything.
Yeah.
But you can tell that it's kind of beefy flavor, but. It's still got a long way to go.
It's just the legs.
Early stages, early stages.
So if you are running out of time, just like these two chefs, we only have 10 minutes ready.
For the restaurant one, I've got a box I have to check here.
Ooh. Yay.
It's a beautiful box. What's in it? Are you ready?
Is it a live one?
What is it?
Ah, ta-da! Ah,
that makes sense. The one we went to in Seoul, it had a sweeter flavor. Oh. And some of our secret is actually, this is sugar.
So you're gonna put sugar.
Oh, okay.
So it's just the taste that sugar gives, like the sweet taste?
Well, you're gonna get a lot of sweetness here. Mm-hmm. From the radishes. And you'll get a little sweetness and nuttiness from the soybean sprouts. Mm-hmm. You'll get sweetness from the onion as well. Mm-hmm. But I guess, you know, 50 years of tradition at their restaurant, they're not gonna change a thing, you know? And this was the original recipe.
I see.
It's what made the working man happy that was visiting that place 50 years ago, and it's what works today.
I'm gonna put some soy sauce in there.
Soy sauce.
Just a little bit.
There are so many kinds of soy sauce in Korea.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And is that. Is it
this jin-ganjang
is jin-ganjang. It is jin-ganjang.
Mm-hmm. Because Joseon ganjang is a little bit salty. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit over salty.
A little bit different.
It's still different. Like, okay, here's the expert.
Jin-ganjang use some. Sweetness fermented with the wheat and it makes some sweetness.
I see.
And just like bukganjang made with meju. Meju means like smashed cooked bean.
Right.
And make the shape and put in the salted water.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I just have one kind of soy sauce and growing up in Australia and then.
What kind do you have?
Just soy sauce. There's, I'd like some soy sauce. Mm-hmm. We only have one, sir, here. And then I've come to Korea and everyone's like, oh no, but there's this soy sauce and this soy sauce and this. Like, I just want soy sauce. Which one should I eat with my mandu or my like?
Yes. Oh, you're putting in the sugar.
Gotta sweeten
Ta-da.
It up. You know, so much Korean food is all about that balance between the sweet, the spicy, and the sour. Mm.
Did you just call lion sugar?
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh. So sweet.
Yeah. This is what happens when both the chefs are single.
Sorry. Next time we bring in married chefs.
It seems like we're getting to the kind of the end of the race here where it's almost time to. It actually seems like Lion's actually in his zone now, and it seems like Jin-ho's getting a little rushed.
Yeah, it's the opposite.
He's like, it's almost like something hasn't gone right, and he's kind of like trying to correct it.
This isn't it.
Has something not turned out the way you hoped?
No, it's okay. Yeah.
Really?
It's all good.
Because you have a completely different look on your face as to what you're saying right now.
You look really I'm okay. I'm not in trouble.
That's pretty close.
All right. I'm gonna count 10 from now on, shall we?
Yes.
All right, 10, 9, 8,
7,
6,
5,
4,
3,
2,
1.
Time's up.
We'll be right back.
are finally ready with two traditional Korean food, and let's get started to eat.
Let's do it.
Go, let's go. So which one are you going to
try?
That
one, that one, or that bowls one? Here.
I think you got to move it.
Yep.
You can,
you can we'll taste
it.
Oh,
the smell.
Oh, will taste? Do you like that?
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, go ahead with it. Just for Tina.
It's really cold right now, so mm-hmm. it's perfect for the winter. Mm-hmm.
It is actually a really good dish for this time of year.
Right?
Just it kind of, it really warms you up.
It's really good.
Oh, yeah.
It's very
it's
soft.
It's pretty soft, and sweeter. Wow. Mm-hmm. I need to try that one.
Excuse
too.
Me, sir. Lots fun. Of meat in mind, please. Would be greatly appreciated.
Can I try
actually, Sam.
Yeah, they sure. need to eat as well, don't they?
Well, there's going to be an element of sweetness in any gulgup from all the radish, but thank but you. This one, definitely adding some sugar on top of that. Mm.
That would change.
It's actually the soup that has the sweetness. Sweet time! You actually went to that restaurant.
I think this one is
all right.
more better. Delicious.
Oh, wow! Oh,
yeah.
Because
it's more clear.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Very, it has clean one. No oil at all.
So what do you guys think?
It's gonna be a hard decision because they were both really good. I don't know. I don't know if I can make a decision yet.
All right, should we vote now? So I'm in the center, and you can stand wherever you want.
Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. But your food was amazing, and I was
What about you? You know, Jin-ho already won here, but you know what? Actually, I gotta put my vote over here because Lion actually had this taste with this cleanness and the Korean traditional taste, tempting, yeah, taste.
Okay,
the first round is over, and now we're going to move on to the second round. Stay with us. Do you have these misunderstandings about Korean cuisine? Recipes are too hard to follow. Korean dishes can't be made with foreign ingredients. It's time to shatter those misconceptions. Here are Korean cuisine out to the world. These culinary Avengers will bring Korean cooking to anywhere around the globe. And the first destination for the Cooking Possible team is the United States. America, the home of gut-busting steaks. America's love for beef is unrivaled anywhere in the world. Chef Jin-ho digged into cookbooks to tackle the mission. Chef Ryan looked to his own vegetable farm for culinary inspirations. Check out the beef soup with rice and braised beef ribs reinvented by these two chefs. Yes, the first round is already over, and now we are about to start the second round. And for the globalization of Korean food, now we get to have a country as a theme for each day. And today, today's country will be United States of America.
Woo!
Woo! I can see our panel's really excited. Let's check out Ryan's.
Boy, you know, I had to think about it for a little while and talk to some friends even, other chefs, but we've got some cool stuff.
Uh-huh.
All right, from my farm or garden that I have with some other friends.
Right, I heard that you actually grew them here.
That's right,
and
that's
right. And he actually brought from his own garden.
Yeah,
oh
it came out even better than I thought it would. This is a collard green, okay? Here's a fresh collard green.
Wow.
We use these in the South in America all the time.
Mm-hmm.
All right. They actually used lots of ugoji or shiregi, right?
Yes.
Which is the outer leaves of the cabbage.
Exactly.
Right. So you hang them on a string and dry them, and then you've got fiber and you've got some vitamins through the winter to sustain it.
Right.
So we did that with the collard greens.
Wow.
At the
it
farm.
It actually worked it out.
And I'm gonna boil these for a little bit, soften them up, and then I'm gonna pull them apart just like you do ugoji or shiregi. I really liked it when I tested this out yesterday. I hope you guys do.
Oh, then what are you gonna do with the chili powder?
Texas chili powder is something that anyone from Texas is pretty proud of. It's gotta have a good amount of heat to it, but it's not like Korean chili powder because it has a mix of different peppers in there.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Can I smell?
Yeah. There's some jalapeno in here.
Mm.
There's some Anaheim in here.
Mm-hmm,
there's some poblano in here.
Uh-huh.
And some cayenne.
Okay, so
Any other secret recipes that you're gonna put into?
Well, one of the biggest challenges is in America we don't really have giant radish, kind of like a daikon radish. So I tried with kohlrabi, which you can find in the United States pretty easily. This is a purple one, sometimes they're green or white. It's about the same flavor though. So we're gonna use those. We're gonna use this American style shiitake or goji. Maybe some mustard green too that'll be blanched to go in.
Okay, and as far as I remember, jalapeno is not that spicy. I wanna see if it's spicy enough as like gochugaru, like the chili powder in Korea.
Here, take mine. No.
I can ask Tina to try.
Can I ask them? Can I try
some? Yes.
Really?
Let me cut you a thin slice. Huh? It may not be spicy at all, but it'll have a lot of flavor at least. Now there's hot. There's seeds in this one. I'll join you.
No, it's fine.
Okay,
can I try some of the chili powder?
Absolutely.
Oh, you're brave.
Wow, it's actually very like fine and coarse at the same time.
Touch me.
Lots of flavor there, right?
So do you think you can
make
it?
Wow!
It's all organically grown and then dried.
Korean's chili taste of...
Okay.
Yeah, it's gonna be really good.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Can I have some of this when I go home? Like, I wanna kind of feel this, you know? Yeah.
Okay, so way to go, Ryan. Let's try. Okay, thanks. All right, now we have Jin-ho ready and we can't wait to see what you have in your refrigerator.
I got some broccoli.
Yes.
Yeah. A little bit of carrot. I'm gonna use carrot.
Anything you can find in your own kitchen, definitely.
Know.
All over
Butternut
the world.
Squash. And I got whole beef ribs.
Oh yes. You can definitely find this ribs in US. For sure.
And also we have dates.
Dates?
Yeah.
Actually they look like Arab dates.
Yep. It's actually like an Arab thing.
You definitely.
Just bench.
Oh, if you don't have these fruits in the United States or any other countries in the world, you may use a little bit of sugar,
and
just like Ryan did.
Normally, the galbi-jjim is gangmyeon.
Gangmyeon.
But I have a Burmese leek. Yeah, you can find this easy in the US.
Ryan, you have all kinds of alternatives here.
Yeah, that's right.
So, are the chefs ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's go for the second round. Let's get started. Woo!
I'm just putting a knife on it. It's a little bit thick now. So I want to cook it a little bit faster.
Okay.
Yep.
And the magic bag is coming back out again.
Oh, yeah.
Magic bag. It's the favorite bag for women.
Just cut it a little size and just put it in the bag. So I put onion and pears now. There's a little bit of pineapple too, so I'm gonna use this.
I don't know, pair of pantyhose if we don't have those bags.
Actually, at the second restaurant that we went to for sogogi bibimbap, they did use bags so that they could pull the meat out and not cook it,
right.
And then they put it back in.
Are you not gonna use the mung bean sprout this time?
Oh, that's a good question. I'm glad you asked. We don't get a lot of soybean sprouts in America, but we have plenty of mung bean sprouts. So that's what I've got today. Soybean sprouts have more of a nutty flavor. The mung bean are just more of a freshness, but the texture will be similar. Not be exactly like the soybean sprouts, but it's the closest thing that we could do in America, so that's the challenge today.
Okay.
That has a similar taste to the soybean sprouts.
Pretty close, like I said, there's more nuttiness to the soybean sprout, I think. And there's more, a stronger texture, or it's firmer, it's usually larger. Or what we often see in like egg rolls, Vietnamese style. Ever since I was a kid, I've seen this in the grocery store readily available in the States. So that was my first go-to to compensate for the lack of Korean ingredients here and there.
Cool.
finished right. Branching.
Whoa. Watch this color change. Okay. I love it. Wow.
Wow.
This is so very Korean, but you could easily do this in the States if you just
come and watch.
Hang and dry your collard greens for a little while. Watch the color come
it
back in this.
Wow.
It'll give a nice green and yellow color there. And one thing you do have to do differently from the Korean shidaege, these stems would be a little too chewy, so I'm gonna remove those later. Mm-hmm. But the leaves themselves taste amazing, mm-hmm. and really, it's a great way to take an American ingredient, but then use it in a Korean way.
Oh, the smell is very earthy.
Right,
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
It's like getting down to the core.
Maybe he didn't watch it, you know?
She's trying to kill us. Gonna get revenge on you guys. You guys.
If you don't have collard greens and you don't have shiitake or the dried cabbage leaves, or sorry, the dried radish top greens, or ugoji, the dried cabbage leaves on the outside, right. Then you can just take napa cabbage and you can boil it, blanch it, take it out, squeeze it, and you can use that instead.
Oh, okay.
With pretty much any green.
Very good tip.
I got secret ingredient.
Really?
Yep.
Okay, let's see.
You?
Oh yeah, you can find that everywhere in US.
Yeah, I know.
Wow.
This is my soy sauce.
Oh. So if we don't have Korean soy sauce.
Yeah, it's a little bit sweeter, it's a little bit more stronger, but it's almost like jjimbap.
Oh, okay, very similar taste.
So I'm gonna put a little bit of soy sauce. I'm gonna put some base on it.
Okay. Oh my God, the visuals, the design. I know that design is always important.
Yeah.
It already looks like
galbi-jjim.
Actually, galbi-tang.
Galbi-tang.
I've got something. I'm from Texas mostly.
Uh-huh.
And my mother doesn't like me eating these too much. Who doesn't love oysters?
Oh, oysters. Right? Oysters. Well, it's perfect time, isn't it?
It is oyster season here in Korea. I just bought a giant box for about $15.
It's really cheap now.
Wow.
Yes.
Oh, so cheap. And actually, I'm not going to put the oysters in the sogogi gukbap. Mm-hmm. Of course not. But I am going to use kind of the water from the shell as a flavor enhancer, as a brining tool, rather than just using salt.
Okay. So instead of using salt, you get to use those.
Right, right. A little bit of that. And then I'm going to make a little side dish with the oysters for everybody to try, so everybody gets to eat some oysters.
Wow, that's...
Yeah, this... you know, limes are a little hard to find in Korea, so whenever I get one, I get really excited. This is one of the favorite ways
to have lime juice.
Oysters. So. A little bit of that. I'm gonna get a little bit of the homemade organic chili powder in here.
That's just lion's the side dish, right? Then what about Chef Jin-ho?
Oh, I didn't get the side dish ready.
No?
Because I just want to try his side dish.
I might put a little bit of salt. Would anyone like to try a little bit?
Jin-ho, it seems like you almost gave up, you know, cooking.
No, I'm not giving up.
Right here, buddy.
Yeah, oh, right there.
Are you trying to interrupt or?
Helping up. I'm just going to try.
Why does Chef Jin-ho stop cooking?
I don't know. Just like
go back to your kitchen, please. Okay. I think he's trying to, you know, get rid of those oysters as possible. But, you know, let us wait. Let us wait.
Okay.
time is up, and it's about time to deliver it. Shall we go ahead?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's taste it, and you know, you can choose who the real winner is.
Okay, food.
¿100% natural ingredient?
Okay, it's good.
Mmm, natural ingredients, yep.
Oh.
I promise this.
Wow.
This is more than Korean.
You use the Texas chili powder to make it sizzling, right?
Right, made my own Texas chili powder. It's kind of hard to find in Korea, so.
Mm-hmm. Broccoli.
It's very interesting. And the texture too is very similar, kind of.
This time the meat.
Radish.
I don't really like it.
You know, we need to change. You're not gonna eat it all up, you know?
Right. Mm.
Anyone else like to try?
I think it's quite different.
This is very mild.
Yeah, it is quite mild.
So this is good.
All right.
Time's up. Are you ready?
How are we gonna do this? Like, we're gonna go.
We need to stand up and move around and.
Okay.
I'm gonna move this time.
Oh! Actually, that was with you.
Oh, come to me.
Although I like the side dish.
I'm gonna move this.
Really?
Yeah, all right.
Huh? Wednesday?
We're gonna have a tie.
I have to say I like
it. Okay, So we have two winners today. It's actually even, right? Mm-hmm. Oh, thank you, Jin-ho, and thank you, Ryan. It was a great cuisine, and you know, I can't believe that we could actually have this here with different ingredients. All right, way to go. Thank you.
Thank you.
So, Soyeon, what did you think?
It was really fun, and it's very interesting that making a real Korean food with the USA ingredients, and it's really awesome that the real taste come up. Yeah. So yeah, thank you for the good food for us.
My pleasure.
Thank you very much. That was great.
Wow.
Okay. Thank you all judges, and thank you to Chez. Thank you very much. It was great having you here. All right. Do you still think it is hard to find the ingredients and it is difficult to cook Korean food? Not anymore. If you're with Cooking Possible, you can always become the chef. All right, we'll always get back to your kitchen with much more surprising Korean cuisine. Thank you for watching us, and see you next time. Bye. Goodbye.
Oh, that's a good question.
No, no, it's okay.
You have a completely different look on your face as to what you're saying.
You don't have girlfriends, as well.
Oh, the favorite bags are women.
Yeah.